Well, howdy, howdy, howdy. I am coming to you live, and I've got some questions for you. Anyway, I got a question today. It said, will I be able to sell 30 hot dogs an hour? Well, that's kind of a loaded question, isn't it? Like loaded to the teeth question. You know, will I be able to sell 30 hot dogs an hour? Well, it depends. If you leave your cart in your garage, probably no. Unless you got a trick I don't know of. But here's the deal. It comes down to location. And what we do is we look for in locations. Let me turn this off real quick, send them to voicemail. We look for locations that will provide us that little window of opportunity from about 11 o'clock to about, two, okay, max two, 1:30. Some people quit about 1:30, some quit at one. Okay. So some work about 2 hours, but we want that window of opportunity. You may find a good place that's busy, but if they're busy and they're busy all day, it looks busy, but maybe you don't have enough customers during the lunch period, which is what you typically want, right? Unless you're working a bar at night or something like that, but typically you want from 11 to about 1 or 2 to be crammed busy. Sometimes we found 10:30 to about 1:30 is really good too. So you've got to look at all that stuff. And so it is one of those things that you're going to have to try it out. But I look for locations that have customer flows into a business that I am sitting in front of, okay, that is at least around 70 customers an hour. During those periods, that will narrow it down so that I can know that if I get a little less than half those people buy a hot dog, I'm good to go. Typically, though, you know, you'll end up averaging about 50% of the customers that go in and out of a place you'll get during a lunch period, depending on the type of place you're sitting in front of. You know, if you're sitting in front of a vegan bar, you're probably not going to sell a lot of hot dogs. No matter how many customers come in and out. But my point is, if you're sitting at a auto parts store, a pull aparts, or a garden center, or a Tractor Supply, or a co-op, or the courthouse, you're going to be busy. And my goal is always in my lunch period, 11 to 1:30, 11 to 2, let's say, is about 100 customers. Well, that's 33 meals roughly. That's roughly 200 hot dogs. That's my goal when I go out. I always set a goal. Now, I can't control a lot of that, but what I can control is where I'm sitting up next time, right? And so I start narrowing that down and finding the place to be that's the most profitable. And we talked about that recently on a show. You'll need to go back and look at that. If you missed it, go to learnhotdogs.com and check it out. We keep them all there for you in order. And then and categories, so you can find it quick. Record keeping, just type in records, record keeping, bookkeeping, type in any of those words in the search box and you'll pull it up. I want to news today. This made my freaking week. You know, I told y'all yesterday I had a bad week. It was bad. And thank you for all the people that are saying stuff here and yesterday that wished me well. Everything's fine, you know, but we all have problems. Okay. I'm not whining to you. I'm just telling you why I wasn't there Monday. I'm telling you why I wasn't there Tuesday. So, today though, we got the, contract, to provide carts for NASA. Unbelievable. Our first one will ship out here next week to NASA over in Cape Canaveral. And it's exciting that a big dog cart is going to be serving astronauts and astronaut type people at NASA. That's freaking awesome. Tell me that. How do you get better than that? We'll have a cart at NASA. So maybe they'll take one of, you know, our carts to the moon or to the Mars. You never know. I mean, probably you do know, but probably ain't gonna happen, but wouldn't that be cool? I thought it was cool. The I want to talk about something else, though. I want to talk about something else. A lot of us face adversity. We all have faced stuff. If I could talk one-on-one with you right now, you'd tell me, yeah, Ben, 2 years ago, we went through, and you'd tell me your story. And we all do. We all do. Some of us worse than others, right? We all do. Dave the Lunchpad says, yes. Dave, I didn't even know it was coming. I thought I had lost the deal. Because I was out of town and I missed an important meeting and I said, I don't care, family first kind of deal. That's the good part about this business is you can say family first and say, see ya, emergency fishing trip, got to go, or whatever. This wasn't an emergency fishing trip, but, I wish it had been. but we all face obstacles, right? I had a guy send me an email today and he was thanking me, he's being kind and generous with later with you, but he gave me like docious for me to read you. He mentioned this quote in his email. He said, obstacles are opportunities to display mastery. And I went, I don't think I've ever heard it worded that way. Obstacles are opportunities. They are opportunities for us to display mastery. And even if we don't feel like we mastered it, the fact that we tackle those obstacles, that's mastery in itself. It makes me happy. But I want to tell you something else. If you're not seeing obstacles in your life, in your business, most importantly in your business, sometimes life just gives you some obstacles, right? The fact that you're alive today and were yesterday instead of being dead today tells you that. Did y'all see that bee just freaking fly and hit me in the face? Anyway, the fact that you're alive today, you're going to have obstacles. That's part of life. But what about in business? Well, if you quit getting obstacles in business, you're not setting your goals high enough. You're messing up. Okay. I set my goals beyond even what I think I can do, and then I double them. Because I know that even if I fail at getting to the creme de la creme, I've gotten far better and further than I would have. So if you're not seeing obstacles in your business, if you're not having a challenge to face, oh my gosh, I booked 2 catering events. Oh my gosh. We have this event. We don't have the money to even buy the product for. I didn't think we'd get the event. Good problems to have. Obstacles. It means you're going forward. It means you're working. It means you're doing the right things to make the right money so that you can better your life. If you're not seeing obstacles in business, then you're in a freaking rut. You need to get your butt kicked. You need somebody to kick you in the pants right outside that rut and get on with it. Okay, set some goals today. Set some plans. Set some priorities. Set some things even out of your reach. Okay, do something different tomorrow. Say, you know what? I'm going to get up and do 20 push-ups, and then I'm going to eat a salad for breakfast. Why not? Right? Change it up a little bit. Mix up life a little bit, and then set a goal that by the end of July you're going to have your second cart or your third cart. Set a goal that you're going to have a catering cart that you don't have to touch ever, ever. If you're a part of the Vendors United group, you know what I'm talking about. But either way, set a goal. Set a goal. It's going to have some obstacles that come with it. I guarantee you. But does it matter? You'll not progress. If you don't see obstacles, then you're stuck. You're in the status quo. You're in the, here I go. I don't want that life. I want to create more and do better. We got a vendor, Michael Wood, out of Georgia. Y'all know, a lot of y'all know him, Doug's Dogs, good is his slogan. And he doesn't have to go out and do this. He loves it. He went from three, he's been for years, he's been 3 days a month. That's his work schedule with Dog Vending. Then he went to 6 days this year. He went to 6 days and added catering into it. Now he's booked up, I think, through October or September, something like that. Why? Why has he done that? Because he set new goals. And he's created new obstacles. He started having to take more stuff to work. So he had to get a trailer to haul the stuff for his cart. He puts his cart in there, puts his generator in there, puts his supplies, his backup supplies, his redundancy stuff. You know, if you got something breaks, I got a backup for it. He did that because he has obstacles. He has obstacles because he created new goals. He created new challenges in his life. And we have lots of vendors doing that. We got Corey Lawrence. We got Michael. We got Jason. We got Terry. We got Susan. We got a ton of vendors, and I could go on and on. Adam, we got a ton of vendors doing that. Jason, there's a bunch of vendors doing that. But no matter what you're doing, you may be watching this, seeing this for the first time and going, I ain't going to vend hot dogs. I work at a tire shop. Well, set yourself some freaking goals. Change it up. If you don't have an obstacle tomorrow, you didn't set big enough goals. Set some goals and change your life. Okay, I'm going to move this down and look who's been on here. I wasn't watching comments and stuff. Billy Blair says, hey, Corey Lawrence says, loaded. I like that, loaded. Billy, howdy, Billy. Jason, hey, Ben Street Dog's here. Jim Hood, Naked Dog is watching. Thanks for being here, Jim. David Ray's here. Ben, Bulldog, hot dogs in the house. Hey, Ben, hope your family emergency has been resolved to your satisfaction. A lot of it was out of my control, and it has been resolved, and I appreciate y'all. Look, Corey says 10:30 to 1:30 typically. See, I nailed it. I nailed it. And there's a vendor that vends a lot and been vending for years, and there you go. Started with a build-a-cart, you know, he built his own cart. You can go to buildacart.com if you want to check that out, buildacart.com. But anyway, built a cart. Then he moved up to a trailer, then he moved into a restaurant, still has all the carts and trailers and stuff. He's got everything. He runs it all. And now he's got a Cater Pro, and he caters. He does all kinds of stuff. Now his customers can order online with a phone app. Okay, a phone app. They can order online, pull up to the window, and pick it up. It's beautiful. Thank you, Thunder Dogs. Thank you. NASA. I had to share that. How do you not? Even if people go, oh, you're bragging. You know what? I don't care. I am bragging. It makes me happy. I don't know how I fell into that dumb luck, I guess. You know, a blind squirrel will find a nut every now and then. Dave the Lunchpad says, yes, pretty cool. That is coolicious. Dave says, karma. The Great American Hot Dog Stand, contract to provide feed locked up on me. Contract. Oh, I'm sorry, man. I'm sorry the feed locked up on you. That's Mark Lawler, the Great American Hot Dog Stand. Hate the feed locked up, brother. Jason Oliva. Ben, I've been taking your advice and applied it 100%. I average 60 dogs an hour. I'm reading your book a second time. Do it. You know, there is a vendor here near me. He's across the mountain over in near Raleigh area, kind of Greensboro area. And he's been vending a few years. He's no stranger to vending. Never has he's been watching me for years. Never bought the first freaking thing for me. He doesn't even have a cart for me, right? But he's kicking butt, and he's decided to do it more full-time. He's a retired detective. He's smart as heck. I love him to death. Him and I get on the phone, and we talk way too long. And he just got my book, and he told me he was reading it for the third time in less than a week. He said, I wish I'd have had this before. Not that it's life changing. It's more about, you know, you get stuck in a rut. You see things one way, and it's why I like talking to other vendors, because you learn new stuff. As long as you open minded, but never open your mind so far your brain falls out. All right. Great American Hot Dog Stands, Carson Nassa, Big Dogs in Space. That's right. I do 50 sit downs every day, Dave the Lunchpad. DL Turner, hey Ben, hey DL, I'm glad you're here. So glad to hear Big Dogs are going to NASA. Going to that base is a, I got in trouble today for the post I made about Adam and Eve. Somebody got mad at me about that, said it's something. Anyway, I thought it was funny. Some people can't take a joke. Anyway, I'd like to have a day every now and then without hitting one. I'd like to have a day every now and then without hitting one. Randy Curtis says obstacles. You know what, Randy? It means you're on the move. Okay. Now, some obstacles we create for ourselves due to, you know, and I'm not saying this to you, but some obstacles we truly create for ourselves with piss poor planning or something. But that doesn't mean all obstacles are that way. So let me quiet this down just a bit. Okay. So I would look at what's creating those obstacles, if they're different every time or is it the same type of obstacle. But I want obstacles. I do. I know that I'm progressing if I have obstacles. So I want them. It's part of making your business better. Set goals bigger than expected. Amen. Corey Lawrence with O'Doggies right there. I'm looking to get started. Rodney, you're at the right place, brother. I've got to get started. Go to learnhotdogs.com and click. Okay. Nothing to pay for. Just click the button. Start watching. Warren Russell's in the house. If you've never seen a lemon, awesomeness, check out Warren Russell. You can message him right here from this page. Just message Warren Russell there and get the best lemon squisher on the planet. I need starter tips. Rodney, yeah, I've got them for you, brother. I've got them step by step, and I even put it in short video format. You can go to learnhotdogs.com, click start here, and you'll be hooked up. If you want some, if you're starting with little to no money, or you're already in business and you're struggling, I've got 2 ebooks I released. They're free, absolutely free right now. They're going to be courses. They will be. You'll have to buy them later. Right now, you can get them free. Go to learnhotdogs.com/get it. /get it. G-E-T-I-T. All together. Get it. And get it. All right? D.L. Turner says, your book is the best. Only one book better. And that's the Bible. All right, brother. Thank you, D.L. Heck, I'm up there with the Bible. That's saying something. And I bet you D.L. voted for Trump. And Trump says the second book of the Bible is his book about business. So I'd take even being third place. I'd take that. Bubba Mason. Hey, Ben, I'm glad you're here. Kristen Holtz, I love listening to you and learning from your experience. Thank you, Kristen. I appreciate it a bunch. That's very kind. And I'm going to post this up real quick. Obstacles, you better have them. Better have them. If you want to do better, if you want to grow, if you want to make more money and spend less time, watch this stuff. Go. Ben, I get calls. Ben, you got so many videos. I don't want to go through them. It's too much information. I just don't know what to do with it. I don't want to have la, 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 right? Okay. You can look at it one way, or you can go, you know what? I'm going to eat this elephant. I ain't going to get it all done at one time. I'm not going to be able to swallow it whole. So what I'm going to do is take one bite at a time. Make yourself a rule. Commit every day to use 15 minutes, 15 freaking minutes a day, and learn something new. Learn something new. Read 4 to 5 pages out of your favorite book, or pick up a new book and learn something new out of it. There's so much to be gained if we keep feeding ourselves. You know, we have to feed our bodies, but we also have to feed our brains. And so I feed my brain every day. Every day I read something. I read something. I either go to a blog, or I'll read something inspirational, or I'll take a chapter out of this book. I do something every day. You should too. I hope you do. I appreciate y'all being here, and I enjoyed this. Kenny Allison, hey, brother. Glad you're here. I'm glad y'all are here with me, and I hope that you'll come back. I'll be back probably tomorrow with something cool. I hope you have a great weekend. I'd love it if you're out vending. Share a picture on our page here. Throw it up there. Throw it up. Castle Concessions, you didn't miss a dang thing, brother. All you got to do is hit the rewind. Hit rewind and watch it. All right? You got a question, post it up. And Heather watches those. Paulo watches those. And we'll post them up. I'll try to answer them on my next one. I love y'all, and y'all have a good rest of the day. Thanks for all the well wishers, and thanks for being here. Love you.